गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, मैसेल्फ डॉक्टर विजेंद्र सिंह तावर, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन एन इंग्लिश. प्रेजेंटली आई हैव बीन पोस्टेड एट गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज गुड़गांव. इन द सीरीज ऑफ वीडियो लेक्चर्स व्हिच आर बीइंग प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज वीडियो इज मेंट फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट थर्ड, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर सेकेंड. And in this video, we have just talked on about the character of Rosie. Rosie in the guide, composed by or written by R.K. Narayan. About R.K. Narayan, we all know that he was born in 1906. That is 1906 and died in 2001. From the very early, from very beginning of his life, he wanted to be a writer, wanted to be an author, but he could not get success in the initial stage of his career. He used to write his compositions and took them to the publisher. They were not published, either he was rejected or not encouraged. So once he met Graham Greene, a famous author of England, the first thing he suggested to R.K. Narayan that his full name, Rasipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swamy, should be shortened. And at the suggestion or request or command, whatever you may say, R.K. Narayan shortened his name from Rasipuram Krishna Swami Iyer Narayan Swami to R.K. Narayan. And now we know R.K. Narayan in itself has become a name, and he is one of the greatest English language novelist of the world. And he is famous, known for his works which were composed around or based in the fictional town of Malgudi. Malgudi is a fictional town. It is not anywhere in India, but if we try to understand the features and geographical features of the town, we can say that it is somewhere in South India. His works showcased his ability to highlight the social context and provide a feel of characters through the simple narration of everyday life. He describes everyday routine work and activities of his characters, and from that he presents the social context. R.K. Narayan was often compared to the William Faulkner, since both their works brought out the humor and energy of ordinary life, that is common man's life, and also displayed compassionate humanism. Means he never tried to violate the boundary of humanity. Along with Mulk Raj Anand and Raja Rao, Narayan forms the triumvirate of Indian literature in English. We can say these are the three top novelists of Indo-Anglian literature. He is credited with bringing English language writing from India to the rest of the world. He introduced India to the rest of the world, and the writers from different parts of the world started taking interest in India. The Guide is the most popular novel of R.K. Narayan. It was written in 1958 and awarded Sahitya Academy Award in 1960. It is Narayan's masterpiece and has been translated into several languages of the world, many languages of the world, and it is taught in many countries. It has become an immortal classic of the world literature and has a special appeal for the East as well as the West. it breathes an aroma of typical Indianite. Aroma means smell, quality, that Indianness is there in this novel. The novel is thoroughly Indian, not only in its character, but also in its theme, scene, and ideas. The novelist catches its Indianness in the form of social and economic life of the country at that time. It holds a mirror to the Indian society of the 30s. In other words, the author has presented in the novel the society of that time, that is of the 1930s. What kind of society, social values, religious values, etc., have been presented in the novel. He captures the rapidly changing social, economic, and religious values of that time, of the 1930s. It is a fact that everything goes on changing at any time. In 1930s, there was change in the Indian social system, economic system, and religious values. And the author has presented that in a very effective manner. The novel depicts the story of a love triangle, husband, wife, and infest lover. Now let us come to the main character. Rosie is one of those butterfly types of women who frequently appear in the novels of Narayan. Narayan has created many such female characters, and Rosie is one of them. She is the heroine of the novel. She has a charming and fascinating personality. Raju falls in love with her at first sight and say, Raju said, she was not very glamorous, if that is what you expect. But she did have a figure, a slight and slender one. Beautifully fashioned, eyes that sparkled, a complexion not white but dusky, which made her only half visible as if you saw her through a film of tender coconut juice. What the author wants to present before us about Rosie's personality, that Rosie was not very beautiful. She was not a glamorous lady, but her features have a special kind of attraction for any young person. Her arrival at Malgudi with her husband Marco plays havoc with the life and career of Raju, the popular railway guide. When she arrived in Malgudi, Raju was very popular and he was earning lot of money, but her arrival and her contact with her changed the life of Raju. Born in a family of dancing girls, the Devdasi, she knew who her mother was, but not her father. Rosie was the daughter of a Devdasi. In South India, many girls were married to God. They had to live in temple. They had to give their all kind of services to the visitors. That is, so daughters and sons are born. They are known by their mother, not by their father's name. She is one of them. But her mother did not want that she should also lead that kind of life. So she was sent to college. Rosie got a college education. She was an MA in economics. She marries Marco, not out of love, but out of respect for his high position and is devoted to him in spite of his impotence and priggishness. Here we should keep in mind that Rosie married Marco because she saw an advertisement in the paper. She went there, she was selected, and they got married. It was not because of love, because Marco wanted a beautiful wife, and Rosie wanted a social high status husband. And but there is one thing very much Indian. She remained faithful to her husband in spite of her being not a man and his self-righteousness attitude. However, she finds it difficult to live with that eccentric fellow. Marco dislikes all that Rosie likes. He is interested in ruins and caves. He takes no interest in his young and charming wife. In other words, Marco was interested in beautiful statues made of stone, but not of a human being, was of flesh and body, that is his wife. They often quarrel and she remains sad, but Rosie's inherited feeling for dams cannot be suppressed as she got a DNA from her mother, her love for dance. She was very much in love, very much liked dancing. When she gets a chance to perfect that, she seizes it. And she tries to establish herself as a dancer. She finds in Raju all that Marco lacks. That is why she feels drawn towards him. In her weak moments, she commits adultery. She is terrified at the thought of herself. Means of being an Indian, though she was attracted towards Raju, they had physical relationship, but when she came into senses, she was feeling that she had committed a sin. And she tries utmost to be accepted by Marco, but he rejects and abandons her. She tells everything to her husband Marco, and she was hoping that Marco would forgive her, but that did not happen. Marco rejected her and left her at the railway station. See here, moreover, he says to Rosie, "You are a woman who will go to bed with anyone that flatters your antics." Antics, here he refers to dancing. That is foolish, outrageous or amusing behavior. He did not like her dancing art. He does not know that he himself has to be, he has got to be blamed for her aberration. That is from norm. Aberration means a departure from what is normal or usual or expected. Means abnormal behavior. But basically, Rosie is a good girl. She is amazed that her husband does not throttle her, did not kill her, by strangled her, her infidelity, and is deeply grateful to him for it. When her husband throws her out and Rosie has no other place to go, she comes to Raju. More than the attraction of sense is the desire to perfect her art. When she was compelled by the circumstances to go to Raju, but it was not because of sexual satisfaction. She was going there. She was going to get a chance to perfect her art of dancing and realize her in fully in her God-given gift. She does not take long to achieve eminence. When Raju introduces her to the theatrical world, she earns fame and money in no time. In very short time, she was able to leave an impression in the mind of the audience because of her talent. But with fame come unceasing demands on her time and energy. She has to fall into a routine and go round and round like a bull yoke to an oil cruiser. Means she became just a tool in the machine, going round and round, earning money, etc. Her individual, her social, her emotional life was not given any importance. Her weariness of it all is like that of any film star. Nowadays, we can see many film stars, same kind of feeling is experienced by them. She is being exploited but sticks it out. When she finds that her husband has produced a masterpiece, she cuts out his picture from the illustrated weekly and puts it on her dressing mirror. Means from her heart, she still loved Marco. She is surprised by Raju's behavior in the matter of the book and later by the forgery, but she does not walk out on him. Means she was not happy with the behavior of Raju regarding the illustrative weekly book and also the forgery committed to get her jewelry. And she did not leave Raju. She tried to bring him out of the problem or that critical situation. To get him out of the mess into which he has got, she dances day and night and is willing to go round like a parrot in a cage or a performing monkey. And she fulfills her duty as a friend. When Raju is jailed for 2 years imprisonment on the charge of forgery, she reconciles, she adjusts, makes adjustment with her husband and earns more popularity as a dancer. If this was the story, if we make a comment or analysis, we find that Roji is a quaint mixture, strange mixture of a domestic woman and a harlot. Means she performs or fulfills her duty as a domestic lady as well as a harlot. Domestic has many responsibility. She tried to fulfill them, and harlot means her body should be so attractive that she can attract her lover. So we find both the qualities or features in Roji. She comes up to the principle of D.H. Lawrence. D.H. Lawrence has rightly said that an ideal woman should have something of a harlot in her. This should have a body who can attract the attention of any person. She has it and that in quantity. Her psychic life is interesting from the point of view of its search for adjustment, which is evidently denied to her. The second, in her case, the marriage is a failure. The fulfillment of the same is still a dream. Her husband understands the language of the ruins better than the requisites of a woman's soul. When she should be in the arms of her husband, she is apart to note that he is still poring over the cryptic meanings of the researches in his room. Means her husband was interested in the statues of stones, not of human soul and blood and flesh. The spiritual void is pathetic indeed. Means spiritual emptiness is very pathetic. Then she turns towards her lover for fulfillment. The physical fulfillment is granted at his end, but not the spiritual one, because it gets tainted by rank commercialism. It is threat to her sex life again. Here again, she gets a lover who fulfills her requirement of the body, but her spiritual requirement was not fulfilled. She realizes that he is also interested in only money, and after some time she realizes that she will also not get sexually satisfaction also with him. Roji has all the weaknesses of a human female. She was an ordinary girl. She has all the weaknesses. Biologically, she is a healthy organism. She was fit and healthy. The novelist has conceived this character with his sense of fine delicacy. Very delicately he has created this character. He adds more romantic colors to her already romantic attitude. Her intricate personality has been delineated with candor, very frankness. The novelist, however, is not interested in the elaborate emotional side of the woman. Means in this novel, we do not find what kind of feelings or her emotional side is not presented by the author in details. the social motive soon invades the possibility of an elaborate emotional life. When we get the situation that now we will come to know about the emotional feelings of the our character Rosie, we find that soon we are surrounded by or attacked by our attention. Our attention is attracted by some social motive. In spite of her quarrels with her husband, she has her loyalties intact. Means she is towards the end of the novel, she was loving her husband. She has a great love for her husband in spite of his being not physically fit. Her body gets intruded upon by the love of another person, yet in her heart she remains concerned with Marco. In short, we can say that she is the only character in the novel that changes and grows and recovers from folly as the novel progresses. And she is the only character who is a changed, we can say round character, who was not the same character which we see in the beginning and in the end. She realizes that she has committed certain mistakes and she changes herself according or adjusts herself according to that. Thank you very much.